In this movie, I'll show you how to use the last of the shape tools, which actually isn't a shape tool at all. It's this guy right here. If you click and hold on whatever shape tool you're seeing inside your toolbox, then notice down here at the bottom of the toolbox, it's the flare tool. And as opposed to drawing a shape the way the other shape tools do, this tool draws a ton of lines and shapes in order to create a special effect. So, in other words, it just happens to be grouped with the shape tools. Still, I want to show you how it works because it's a fair amount of fun. And we're going to use the tool to achieve this effect right here, which gives us a little bit of bounce on the inside of the magnifying glass. All right, so if you're still out there working with me, go ahead and click on the Lone Star layer to make it active, and then drop down to the tiny page icon at the bottom of the Layers panel and Alt or Option click on it to bring up the Layer Options dialog box. I'm going to call this layer Flare, and I'm going to change its color to green, and then I'll click OK. All right, now what you want to do is drag with this tool. And I'm going to start a little bit down and to the left of the center of the star, right about here. And notice as you drag, you're just going to create a cacophony of stuff. So basically, we have a ton of rays that are coming out from the center of the drag. And then we have this halo, which is represented by those two rings. Now, you can change the number of rays, much as you might expect by now, by pressing the down arrow key in order to reduce their number, or pressing the up arrow key in order to increase their number. You can also press the control key or the command key on a Mac as you drag in order to change the size of that halo. Can you see how that outer ring is expanding and contracting? And that's a function of pressing and holding the control key or the command key on the Mac. And you can also press the space bar if you like in order to move this effect on the fly. And you don't really need to worry about getting it exactly right because you can always come back and change it later, as I'm about to show you. All right, after you do that, you can click and drag a second time to create these rings that are emanating from the flare effect. All right, now let's say you want to edit this wacky effect you've created. You have one of two options. Notice your cursor, if you look very carefully, appears as a kind of cross with some dots around it. If you move your cursor over the center of that ring right there, those lines in the cross, they become tiny itty-bitty arrows, which allow you to then move the rings to a different location. I know, right? And then you can do the same thing at the center of the effect over here near the star. And you can drag that to wherever you like. Not only that, if that's not enough for you, then I'll just go ahead and move this down a little. You also have the option of pressing the Enter key as long as the flare tool is active. That's the return key on a Mac in order to bring up the flare options dialog box. Now, I'm not going to wander through each and every one of these, but I do want you to have a sense for what's going on here. If you change the diameter value, you're going to increase the size of this halo. So notice if I take it up to 400 points, for example, I'm increasing the halo so that it's exceeding the edge of the glass, which is, of course, not what I want. So I'll just go ahead and take that back down to, let's say, 300. You can also experiment with these other center values if you like. The growth value here inside the halo is going to expand how big the halo gets. That is the region between these two circles right here. I'm going to go ahead and take it down a little bit so that we have this kind of edge right there. And you can also change the number of rays if you like. I think I might be up to the maximum at 50 right there. Yes, indeed I am. But I kind of like that effect. You can turn the rays off if you don't want them, like so. Or you can turn the rings off, which is what I'm going to do. I really don't want the rings associated with this effect. And so having done that, I'll just go ahead and click OK in order to apply that effect. And I might move this guy up and to the right just a little bit in order to better fill the magnifying glass. All right, now if you deselect this effect by going up to the Select menu and choosing the Deselect command, or once again, you can press Control-Shift-A or Command-Shift-A on the Mac, you'll see that it's kind of leaking out down here along the bottom left edge of the magnifying glass, which doesn't really make any sense. But you can mask that effect. And again, this is getting a little ahead of ourselves, but I think we should do it, if only in the name of creating quality art. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go over to the Lone Star layer and notice that it has a triangle next to it, which means that you can click the triangle to expand the layer. At which point, I'm going to go ahead and target right there by clicking on a circle associated with that red circle that's located behind the white star. Now you want to press Control-C or Command-C on the Mac to copy it. All right, having done that, just go ahead and collapse that Lone Star layer and then expand the flare layer like so and go ahead and target the flare by clicking on its circle. And that's going to select all that garbage as you're seeing right there, at which point you want to press Control-F or Command-F on a Mac in order to paste that circle in front of it. All right, now what you want to do is drop down to the bottom of the Layers panel once again, and notice this icon right there, Make Release Clipping Mask. Just go ahead and click on it, and that will convert that circle that you just pasted to a mask. And now everything about that flare is contained inside that circle and no longer leaks into the blue star background. At which point you can go ahead and click that triangle in front of the flare layer to once again collapse it. And now I'll press Control-Shift-A or Command-Shift-A on the Mac to deselect my artwork. And just to make sure I don't mess things up any further using the flare tool, I'll press the V key to switch back to my black arrow tool. And that's how you use the flare tool, the one shape tool that's actually a special effects tool here inside Illustrator.